We hear a lot these days in the media about families in poverty who are struggling. We're told they're making bad choices and need to change. But are families in poverty really so different to others? We spent time with 8 families and surveyed 1,000 parents and children in England, rich and poor, to learn more about what life is like for them. Nick spends pocket money on new clothes. His parents buy him tickets to music festivals, and his uncle arranges work experience in his international company. Rose gets secondhand clothes from her friends, stops asking for a music magazine because mum could not afford it, and works in the local leisure centre. Frances gets an iPad from her parents. She uses it to do homework with her friends and gets annoyed when other kids in her class haven't done homework. George's parents can't afford a tablet. He has to borrow the school's and do his homework there. He does it alone so his friends don't see, and he struggles with homework because he can't take it home, and then feels upset when people think he hasn't bothered. The children who we spoke to, rich and poor, had similar aspirations and ways of doing things, and their families were doing their best to support them. But children in poverty are 5.7 times more likely to be excluded from social experiences, 5.5 times more likely to go hungry, and 5.9 times more likely to have been made to feel ashamed because they don't have money. Children and families in poverty aren't doing anything differently in a way that causes their poverty, but they are having to do extra things to deal with that poverty. Together, we can help these families by campaigning and working to reverse the cuts made to poorest families' incomes, make sure all families have enough to live on, make sure that children in poverty aren't excluded from experiences and activities, change how we talk and think about poverty so that people aren't made to feel ashamed or different.